Todd Grisham. Alongside me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Riddick Moe, 6'5", 240 pounds, with a reach of 81 inches. He'll square off against The Rock. Rocky Marciano, the Brockton Brawler. This heavyweight is anything but standing only 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live.
Nobody knows who's going to win. You can have an argument for the winner on both sides, but this is that fight. We'll be talking about this fight for years to come.
Here comes Riddick, Big Daddy Bo. The Rock, Rocky Marciano, 201 pounds of pure terror. This man is an absolute machine.
They have waited for this fight for...
Heard of people dancing underneath the moon? These two fighters promised us an offensive show. Let's see if they deliver. He blocks that jab. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. You know that bell was sweet music to his ears.
Needs a knockout, without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you're getting it. You're getting it.
Here we go. Round two. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
Speed generates power. Timing is everything. If you've got speed, you can pop, knock anybody out. You've just got to hit him in the right spot. You know what? You've got skill. You've got... Oh, my goodness. I admire these guys.
You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You've got a swarm on your case. You know you've got to fight. You've got to hold him. You've got to tie him up. You've got to lean on him when you come in until the referee makes you break off. But keep your hands high, because they will keep punching until the referee said stop.
Thank you. going to need a knockout. On to the third. Let's see how they bounce back here in this round.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to block it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot. Jab. Rest on the jab. Be smart and tough until your legs come back. Then, put the pressure.
Just missed with that big right hand. Either man really defending themselves. Perfect counter lands. Let's see if these two heavyweights decide to exchange bombs early or decide to box a little bit.
Guys that carry so much power, of course they're going to look for that knockout because it makes a night a little bit shorter. You don't get paid any extra for overtime.
And I just change it from the beginning of this round.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I got to respect both of them more than happy.
Way through the round, and there's not a lot separating these two. Got out of the way of that right hook. Nice counter. And just as quickly as it slows down, it heats back up. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter.
Back at it in round four. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. How do they use the spider's aggression against them?
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get there, they want to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tail. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate how they set their blocks. Get out of the way, and they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't deal with it.
Left counter score. Oh, that punch. That would have backed out of the pocket for you. Look how slow these punches are. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Beautiful counter shot. It prevents that left uppercut from scoring. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight because if they...
Round five. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going.
Yeah.
Big shots from both of these fighters. Got to be careful though. You hear people talk about a boxer's chin? Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
I've seen some fighters with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punchers with a chin like a crisp. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the danger, Scott.
Nice counter shot. Nobody home with that hook. Punch. Either man really defending himself. This is certainly an aggressive fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Catch and shoot with the left counter. Good job. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Great counter right hand there. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
You can't leave it up to the...
On to the sixth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. But this fighter realizes that defense is one of the scoring criteria in boxing. Left counter was perfectly timed. Exchange here from both men. In the early rounds of the fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power. And I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that runs.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for those pointed areas over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them skin and go for speed.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
So close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. One lands. That counter shot lands. He misses with that jab. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Judging. And there's the bell for round seven. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. When you're a power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
Todd, do you know one of these fights can knock you out with a simple jab? They're that powerful.
Just misses with that jab. Punch, counter punch. There's a counter shot. Beautiful counter punch. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Good counter punch for both these athletes. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. He misses with that jab.
skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
How much confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through it?
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And they forget, you can bang too.
Left counterpunch to score. They both want the knockout. This round could go either way, 10 seconds to go. I promise you, all three judges here. There's the bell to start round 8. After a really strong round, let's see if they can finish the job.
My motto is, if it's not broken, change it. An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you won, hands down.
Good left hand. You score with that left hand. This fighter has determined that they can walk through any punches that their opponent throws, and that's a very confident spot to be in.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get bent.
Catch and shoot. Blocks the right uppercut. Bombs away. Still swinging with nothing left. There are no losers in this one. They exchange punches. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
So they don't get complacent.
The fighters starting to get tired as we start round 9. And they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago. Punch. How do they use this fighter's aggression against them?
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're comfortable. Oh, you play cards, no screws.
Big whiff with the right hook. Nice job landing that. Not sure how serious that cut is, but the referee's going to take a good look at it.
Are you okay?
The referee says they're okay to fight. We'll keep fighting. Can they figure out the combination to this safe? They better start respecting each other's punching power.
I've seen it happen so many times. Don't take things for granted.
Both men step back for just a moment. Offensive display landing that left counter. And just missed with that left jab. Missing with the left hook. This Brown with 10 seconds to go. There's the bell to start round 10. What an action-packed round that was. Let's see what they have in store for us here.
Good work the last round. Be smart. Don't get too braggadocious. You'll get turned over and walk into the shot. And that's the last thing you want.
This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
Work the body, frustrate them, take the mind off the shin, take the mind off protecting everything around that. Work the body, use tactics sometimes. It's so hard to actually outbox a fight and beat them on points.
Oh, what a punch! Still throwing punches. These two are the perfect dance partners.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
When you talk about a fighter having power, don't just look at the head punches they throw. Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Still waiting for this round. Still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Going to cause some serious problems.
I hope we've got a good cut.
There's the bell for round 11. Can it get any better? What a round we just saw.
What a round. What have they got left? How can you get better than that? That is ridiculous. That's stuff you see on video games.
What a fight it has been so far. Wonder what we're going to see in this round. Perfect counter shot. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far? Miss with that jab. Lands with the right counter. There, but misses. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. And they figure out the combination to this sink. Nice counter shot. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. On the right. Adages, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
Gotta ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable, drag them, get them complaining to the referee, because once somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
And 10 seconds to go. Let's see what we've got in store for us here.
This is part of the game plan. You knew this was going to happen. Now you've got to stay still in your mind. You've got to think, right, don't get rattled. Don't get swayed by the crowd cheering or booing. Walk straight from there, stick to your game plan, show your shots, and then let it go. But do it at your pace.
inside heel with the jab, but does not land. They won't give us a second to catch our breath. This is not good strategy. Those punches are doing nothing. Counter punching. Counter shot. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you just got to be smart than them. You've got to be like a little favorite and pick something.
Lands. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. The three judges agree and we've got a unanimous decision.
They've done it before, now they're doing it again, and look what's happened. A unanimous decision. What a way, what tactics, what a game plan, what a result.
What they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking, yeah. Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded,
right.
War with the Lord, not our omen, still might have to grill a brother like
Ladies and gentlemen, it is go time. My name is Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Todd, always a pleasure to work with you. Always a pleasure.
It's time for our tale of the tape. And yes, he is the greatest, Muhammad Ali. 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it. He'll face off against the man known as Joe Joyce. 6'6" tall, 210 pounds, and he loves to bang it out.
There's a mad weight difference here. You know what? You're looking at power, you're looking at speed, you're looking at all these things you've got to take into account. When they land, it's going to feel like a mule's kick.
And yet, the juggernaut. Exuding confidence as they touch. And here's the bell to start round one. Both men step back for just a moment. Fantastic punch. Hook hurt him. And just as quickly as it slows down, it heats back up. How did he absorb that hook? Exchanges from both men in this round. He misses with that jab.
perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them more than happy.
Keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
Oh, this is the slugger right here in front of him. He's kind of fighting. They want to get hit in the face because it jeezed them on. They want to stand there and fight in the trenches.
Take that jab. What the judges' scorecards read. There are no losers at this point. Just misses with that jab.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
Nice counter shot. Nice job landing that left counter punch. Correct me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
This can be so frustrating.
Such a fast
and two attackers before three full-shot combinations before you even let one. That creates frustration, and that's when it gets hard.
Okay, the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Nice counter shot with the right hand.
Somebody don't get complacent.
There's the bell to start round two. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. He fails to score that left hook.
Jaw's first blood test. That's what you've got to look at. If you block and you know you're in there with a hanger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this ring. I'd like to see more jabs.
So he's got the chance. They're just trying to figure out how they're going to deal with it. Yes, they need to be offensive and defensive. He's just trying to figure out this is a good spot.
He misses with that jab. Through the hook, didn't land. With 10 seconds left. There's that combo shot. What would you tell this guy? He's got to do something different.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
There's the belt for round five. After snooze and ready to go, let's hope this round is more competitive.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to block it. They've got to block it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then, put the pressure on.
Finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym, you can do it in a fight. You've got to relax.
Swing and a miss with that left hook. Figure out the combination to this safe. Quick punch scores.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of trouble.
You missed with that jab. Tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. And a counter left. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
I seriously hope the judges keep their eye on this fight, because if they haven't...
On to the sixth round. There is no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. One of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
Some fighters are just gifted. Gifted with amazing footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
Action shoot with the left hand. Good job. Sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. And he just missed that left jab. Big shots from both these fighters. Got to be careful there. Stamina is so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want. And you've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. What don't you think?
Willpower.
Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. You get desperate when you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
Second win. You've got to find it somehow. Great counter right. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. From this moment forward, you cannot afford to lose another round. Lose them up top. Here comes round seven. So not the best round, but let's see if they can turn it around here. There's the left, it doesn't score. Nice job landing with that right-hand counter. Perfect counter shot. When are we going to see a jab from these two? Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
You can be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You just gotta use brain.
Big left, but doesn't score with it. These two are the perfect dance partners. Exceptional chin, by the way. And they get out of the way that one time. What the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Well, we know we've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around?
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as a fighter, and the corner is better for a firecracker, and that fighter, get out there and get the job done.
Start round eight. And they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago.
My motto is, if it's not broken, why change it?
An excellent last round. Everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won that hands down.
punches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter. Fast fighters got hand speed and footwork. They're confident. They know they just have to move first. Boom! In a split second, they've got four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed. And that's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. Back and forth they go. Neither fighter willing to back down. Good counter punch. Off the charts action from both of these fighters. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
10 seconds to go. Trainer needs to come in and say something special. Our fighters starting to get tired as we start round nine. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations where just being healthy is going to go out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be extreme again. Don't suck it in. Make you fight your fight. Hold and tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Interested in throwing one shot at a time. They throw combinations and they throw them non-stop.
Having so much speed, what happens to your opponent is that you get caught to ribbons, and that's where the referee has to jump in and stop the fight. And you know this is gonna happen, so you rush your work. You think, I've gotta get him inside close rounds. You've gotta ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable, drag them, get them complaining to the referee, because once somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
Through the hook, it didn't land. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. This fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Just from both men in this first round. Right hook's already working well. Fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
Trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be guessing yourself back trying to get that shot, and that's when it'll catch you.
You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Exchange punches. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. They've got the momentum, they've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
Dominance.
Where's the bell to start round 11? Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
Beautiful counter punch. That one lands. The uppercut. Nice counter shot. Endurance is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on the ground.
What could they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again, and the fight will be over.
What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything.
when he let those shots go and was just bouncing up and then locking you down. It's so demoralizing, it absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
Lands with the right counter. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one.
Unanimous.
You know what? Smart, smart, Sammy.
Total change of styles to make sure they've got it. I've every round in the bag. There was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.
I'm Todd Grisham, and how about this venue, ladies and gentlemen, Brooklyn Hall. And here with me, my broadcast colleague, it's Johnny Nelson.
I feel like a fraud. How have I got these ringside seats?
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. And across the ring from him, Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated.
Talk about
Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. Fighting out of Wood. Rocky. A lot of trash talk between these two fighters. Let's see if they deliver. And this is that jab. You miss with that jab. Offensive display landing that left counter. Exchange here from both men. Punch scores. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Locks the left there.
So close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
See a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
Oh man, you've got swarm in your face. You've got to try and push him off, make him go into the ropes. You've got to sometimes fight fire with fire. Put him on the blind side of the referee. Get him in.
Lands with the right counter. He just misses with that jab. Round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Great counter right hand there. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
I seriously hope the judges keep their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, he's going to be absolutely
what do you expect to see here in round two? Now, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. As it is in most heavyweight fights, don't blink, because one big shot and this thing could be over.
Guys, that carries so much power. Of course they're going to look that knockout, because it makes a night a little bit shorter. You don't get paid any extra for overtime.
Got his gloves up to block the left jab. Another scoring shot there. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Good punch scores. Good counter punches for both these athletes. Fighter has determined that they can walk through any punches that their opponent throws, and that's a very confident spot to be in.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get dented.
You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. You, all three judges here are going to give that round to you know who.
You can't leave it up to the judge.
Here we go in round three. Who's going to land the first big shot? Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. That left counter punch will score. Neither man really defending themselves. Job by him to block that jab. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Two are the perfect dance partner. He gets out of the way of that left hand.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. He misses with that jab. Swinging him in. Left counter was perfectly timed. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this.
On to the fourth we go. Coming off that great round, let's see if they can build on momentum here.
God, my muscle is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won that hands down.
Nice counter. Counter score.
aggressive fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring?
What a shot!
Yeah. one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom.
Came in clean, not without a broom.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Straight in, more pain, so more gaining. Here I came in, guns blazing, at raving, you get weighed in. Been training, sick of waiting, some failing, not plain sailing. Entertaining, check the ratings, let me out, I don't wanna be caged in. Yeah, I'm ready, who's next up? Pay attention now, yeah, your best luck. I like to warm up like a few jabs, and then I hit hard like a left hook. My style's unique, not textbook. Step to me, you get yourself messed up. Win or lose, still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom.
Came in clean, not without a room.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved, I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room,
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room, boom.
Todd Grisham, and we are live here at the one-of-a-kind Empire Fight Camp. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
About time, too.
Time for our tale of the tape. Tyson Fury. He stands an imposing 6'9" tall with a reach of 85 inches. And across the ring for the Gypsy King himself, Rocky Marciano. Rematch drama, and they will. There's the bell to start round one. So there you have it. It is official now, and that is not the way anyone wanted this fight to end.
No complaints there at all. The crowd agree. I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
What a stunning venue. We are live at Brooklyn Hall. I'm Todd Grisham. Next to me, of course, is Johnny Nelson.
I feel like a fraud. How have I got these ringside seats?
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. He is Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. He is Rocky Marciano, the Brockton Brawler himself, one of the greatest fighters of all time. Deontay Wilder. And this one has all of those big fight feels you... to score with that left hook. Forget what we saw yesterday at the weigh-in, fighting at the bit to get it on in this historic venue.
This is that place you want to say, I fought and I beat them, and now we are here.
He just misses with that big right hand. Back for just a moment. Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. It's just like a match made in heaven.
You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You find the swarmer, you've got to protect everything. The body with the elbows, the head with the forearm. You've got to try and push them off balance because they will just stay in your face.
When are we going to see a jab from these two? Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. From this moment forward, he cannot afford to lose another round.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
Raise the bell to start round two. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
He's going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. That leaves more opportunities for headshots. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
Sluggers just want to mow you down. They want to walk straight through as though you do not exist. You've got to be fit for this one.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Neither man really defending themselves.
Totally impressed. You know what? You've got skill. You've got... Oh, my goodness. I admire these guys.
And they get out of the way of that left hand. And he lands a big right hand. He misses with that jab. A light counter. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left.
Rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then
Put the pressure on.
He's got a massive reach of there. This is not the way he wanted this fight to start. Let's see if he can turn out of trouble. Trouble for a while there. Looks like he's starting to get his power back. That was the end, but here we go again. Back into the fire. He just missed with that left jab.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, so I've got to respect both of them more than happy.
We're not going to see as much footwork as the smaller weight classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want the heavy fist.
Couple of big units here, so I'm expecting power. You're gonna have excitement, you're gonna have drama, because when these guys slow down, that's when the punches are gonna
land. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. And a round that seemed like an eternity for them. Finally, on to the fourth we go. After that last round, something has got to change. And he misses with that jab. And he just misses with that jab. Second win. You've got to find it somehow.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hit the back? Can they knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym. You can do it in the back. You've got to relax.
That's counter punch. It's a defense-first game plan so far. These two are the perfect dance partner.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
This has been a very competitive round between these two. Showing exceptional chins, by the way. Threw the hook, didn't land. This round could go either way, 10 seconds to go. Joaquin Marciano covering up. In the early rounds of the fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other and test each other's power. And I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
Trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be gassing yourself out trying to get that shot, and that's when they catch you.
locked into the chest so we can avoid the pain of those body shots, but come on, that leaves more opportunities for headshots. Can they figure out the combination to this thing?
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
That's another scoring shot. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Just missed with that big right hand. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one.
Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.